Hi YouTube world, welcome back to my channel. I thought tonight I feel a little wired. I should be asleep. It's super late at night, but in just a few days I'm going to be traveling down to Miami to see my family, which I have not seen in a very, very long time. What I'm going to be doing over the next few months is I'm going to be traveling back and forth quite often from New York to Miami, catching flights. We're driving down there with my sister, but then I'll be catching flights back and forth just to spend some extra time with my family. My dad's health, he's not well, and we just want to spend some really good quality time with him. And so I thought it would be fun to pack with you guys. Like, think about what makeup I want to bring in. So I hope you see, I started to play around with palettes. So how it's going to work is I'm driving down with my stuff, and when I fly back and forth, I'm not going to be carrying anything with me. So it's easier for me to get on and off flights. It's my parents' house down there. So I'm just going to have a good makeup bag, toiletry bag, anything that I need. This bag is going to live down there for a few months. And so I'm torn between packing things that I really, really love, but also fun items that I think would work better in a place like Miami, where it's a lot warmer, sunnier, more humid. I live a different life there. I'll be coming in and out of a pool or water because I love swimming and I miss it terribly. And so that is something I'll be doing all the time. And so I was thinking, like, what kind of makeup do I want? And when I see friends at night, if I get to see any friends, what kind of fun makeup do I want to play with? So I wanted to bring some new makeup, some old makeup that maybe I want to make a dent in. And I have this cute little baggie. Isn't this adorable? I got this free at Ulta. Or no, actually, it was like $19.50. And I just thought it was so cute. And it's like the perfect size. I don't want to surpass this for makeup. And so yeah, that's what I thought we would do. And so if that interests you, stay tuned. You're going to be able to see some products that I recently acquired, maybe I haven't talked about yet. Maybe I'll chit chat a little bit about them now. And yeah, it'll just be like a fun little video where you hear my thought process on what's important and what can stay. So as I mentioned, I've been struggling with the idea of what to take. Should I limit myself? Am I really gonna want to express myself through makeup? And the truth is, I do like to express myself with makeup all the time. And it doesn't take me a long time to get ready, even if I am doing a full face. I'm pretty quick about it. And so I still want to play with color. I just feel it lifts my spirits. And especially if I'm dealing with a challenging time, like having to go to doctors with my dad and whatnot, I'm gonna want to have little moments to myself, I think, just to clear my head and to be there in a good centered space for my family. I hope that makes sense. So in order for me to do that, I was plotting. And so let's go in order of kind of like face products that I think would work really well. I will be taking with me, even though it is part of my Project Pan, I do think I want to take with me my It CC cream, even though it's on its last leg, along with its light companion. I'm almost done with it. It works very well in very, very hot, sweaty weather. So I thought, let's go ahead and take that with me. Even if I end up bringing this back and forth, like in my bag, I do want to take this with me for sure. It's just kind of like a, I don't have to think too much when I put on this product. That's the kind of makeup I need, the kind I don't think too much about. So this I don't think too much about. The other product that I'm thinking would work, maybe, I don't know, let's see, is this Pixi C Cream, Vitamin C Brightening Perfector. So this is a weird little product. This is like a color changing product. And I think I like it. I'm pretty sure I like it. And I'm pretty sure it's gonna work well down there. It's sort of like a very, very light tinted, you know, comes out white, and as you work it into the skin, it changes color. And it's a very, very light tint. It's a barely there tint. It's just a little more color than what I have. Another product I thought I would do really well with down there, maybe to amp up my glow, is the Healthy Glow Unisex Summer Tint Moisturizer by Charlotte Tilbury, this one here. This is like a very bronzy, glowy product. It's not like overly glowy, similar to that other product that I just showed you. It's white, and then as you blend it in, it just has a slight amount of tint. And I can mix this with moisturizer, I can mix this with sunscreen to give myself like a little bit of a glow. It's nothing ridiculous, but as I predict, I'm gonna be getting some sun, even though I'll be wearing SPF 1000 on my face. I'll still get some sun, and this just will like maybe amplify any kind of glow. So I thought this might be pretty nice to experiment with. And this, in conjunction with something like, let's say, the MAC Studio Fix, a shade N2, this one here, these two together make a nice base product. So I feel like that's pretty good for base, because I feel like I'll finish a cosmetics one pretty quickly. I'm on the fence about Pixi, and between the MAC in combo with the Charlotte Tilbury, I know that that's a winning combination, and I'll feel pretty confident in that. I don't like to layer too much when I'm in Florida because of the humidity. My skin gets a little more combo, less dry. Just want a nice light hydrator underneath my makeup, and I think this one here from Good Molecules, this is the Silicone Free Priming Moisturizer. It's just a nice lightweight moisturizer. I know it calls itself a priming moisturizer, but its texture is like a little gel-like, and it just does a nice job in livening up the skin without adding too much. The sunscreen I'm going to be using from Etude House, it's the Sun Priest. It's brand spanking new. I love this sunscreen. It works beautifully under makeup. It's super lightweight, but effective. I used to take this when I used to go to Jazz Fest in New Orleans, which is like the hottest, sunniest time. And yeah, I just really, really like it. I know it works well. I don't want to experiment with sunscreen when I'm down in Florida. I haven't seen the sun in a really long time, and it's just not the best time to experiment because I will burn like a crispy potato. Do potatoes burn crispy? Well, yeah, eventually. Let's move on to maybe some powder. This one by e.l.f. I think I like. I haven't used it altogether that much. It is the Halo Glow Setting Powder, this one. So let's throw this in the mix and let's give this a shot. So I'm gonna include this one because I feel like sometimes a setting powder actually does help you, especially with all the humidity. Now we get into color products. So I am so torn here. I don't know whether to do cream products. Honestly, cream products, when it's really, really hot outside, they just melt off my skin. I'm going to stick with powder products, and I have quite a few. I'd like some options. That would be my preference. A part of me feels like let's just make this really easy and just take a face palette that has a couple of options, but I also want to have some fun. I got it. So I recently acquired a gorgeous palette, and why not use it? My first By Terry product. Here it is. So this is the Brightening CC palette in Beach Balm. This is it here. It's gorgeous. I've been using it. I love it. Has a really beautiful peach blush, beautiful pop of pink, which I love having that option, especially if I'm going for very colorful eye looks like this. This is a bronzer. This won't be the only bronzer I use, but this is a really pretty luminous bronzer, and this is a very natural kind of looking highlight. So I think this would be a really pretty palette that would give me options. I'm also going to go ahead and tote back and forth my butter bronzer because it's in my project pan. I love it. I know how it performs, and let's make a dent. Let's make a dent in this. And I don't mind lugging this back and forth in my everyday makeup pouch. So I think that that's a good one. Maybe I'll bring a nudie blush I've been playing around with the Buxom Seychelles. This one here. This one's really pretty. It's like a nudie. It's kind of like a very easy breezy sort of color product. And while we're at it, why don't we throw in the Cheek Leaders palette from Benefit. It has Hoola, which is an even deeper bronzer for me right now. It has Gold Rush, which is a pretty sheer. Actually, let's compare Gold Rush and the Buxom. So this is Gold Rush and this is Buxom Seychelles. I feel like I could live with just Gold Rush. What I love about the Cheek Leaders Mini Bronze Squad palette is that it has Cookie as a highlighter, which is so beautiful. And I would be willing to wear a highlighter in Miami. It's a very highlighting kind of place. So I think we're gonna go with that. I think I'm good. Am I good? Oh, that's pretty. Okay, I'm gonna bring one more blush. I'm gonna bring this Bobbi Brown blush. This is in Antigua. I just recently got this and I love it. I love the tone. I just love it. And it is like a vacation. It's softer than the pink in the other palette. So I will bring that along with me. Oh no, I just thought of my other blush. Would it be insane if I bring four blushes? I'm bringing the MAC blush too. Dilly Dolly, Extra Radiance, this one here. Next up, let's do, I have my blush, I have my complexion products. Let's do eyeshadow palettes. I am gonna wanna bring a few eyeshadow palettes for some variety. Eyeshadow palette on my eyes is one that I recently acquired from BH Cosmetics, Lost in Los Angeles. And it is this beautiful thing right here. These shades perform so, so well. I was going crazy applying them and doing fun looks, but I really, really like it. I think there's some just fun colors and it totally reminds me of Miami. This feels very Art Deco to me, very South Beach, and I love it. And I thought a great companion palette to it would be the Limoncello palette from ColourPop, which I recently also got, because this is that palette here. And I feel like it has some great toppers that would complement it. It has this blue and it has this chocolatey brown and some other colors. I feel like together they can really work well. So I'm gonna bring them both. Also, Limoncello has a really nice huge mirror in it, which sometimes I need. Another one that I just probably will throw in my bag and travel back and forth with, because it is my most recent love. It is my Stila Camouflage Beauty palette. It's this one here. I just love it so much. This is more sophisticated, can create much more sophisticated looks than the BH Cosmetics palette. It's just phenomenal. And I'm gonna bring one more for some more like maybe darker, sultrier looks. I also just recently got this LA Girl palette and I'm really impressed with it. This is the Keep It Playful Eye Palette in Downplay. And these are the colors in it. And it's very much like the Huda Obsessions Smoky palette, which I never bought and I was so mad about. But this has a lot of really pretty shades. It has a lot of depth. And so I feel like I can pull from this, but this is also sort of like I don't have to think too much and can create a pretty neutral eye look and walk out the door. So I like the options that I think this will give me. A backup palette that I was contemplating breaking was the Club Nebula palette. Oh, because these colors are also so much fun and so vibrant. Maybe I'm gonna put this in the maybe pile and see if it fits. If it fits inside, I will bring it. If it doesn't, I can't bring it. I think that's a good, pretty good compromise. Let's see what else. Some eyeliners probably would make sense. My eyeliners here. Let's grab some that would be probably fun to play around with. I like always a brightening eye in the waterline, one of those. Maybe some colors. This green would be pretty. Turquoise would be pretty too. Also picking a color that is like pretty run-of-the-mill chocolate. I'm gonna bring Lucky with me because I love Lucky. Lucky's one of my favorite shades, like cobalt, which I think would be fun for looks. And maybe one more neutral leaning shade. Work with the Stila palette. I think mushroom would be really, really pretty. I love mushroom. So I think that's good. Oh, I have this new one, Tiger's Eye. Okay, we'll bring that one too for fun. So that's these here. Also going to bring a pencil sharpener because that's important. And I just bought a new pencil sharpener, the one from NARS. I heard good things about this one from Jessica Braun, so why not? What else is left? Eyebrows. So for eyebrows, I've been enjoying using brow powder for the most part. I'm gonna bring the light brown brow struck. Maybe also bring medium brown. I'll mix the two. So these are from Kat Von D. I really enjoy them. So I also have the Anastasia Brow Freeze. I played with it a bit, but I feel like Miami might really, you know, be a good place to experiment if this really, really works. So let's bring those. Chapstick is always good to throw in there. Love the Glossier Bomb.com. So I'm going to put this inside of my makeup bag, and I'm also going to probably pack another lip balm, and this one probably in my purse, and I'll do Laneige, the Grapefruit Glowy Lip Balm Mascara. I know I just opened the Stila mascaras, so I will leave those here, and I will take with me one mascara, two mascaras. I am going to take with me a brand new Monsieur Big waterproof mascara. This one, I've never tried the waterproof formula, but I feel like down in Florida, that wouldn't be a bad thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and bring it. I'm also gonna bring the Maybelline Colossal Mascara in Glam Brown. This one's brand new because this is brown and it's more of a daytime look. So I kind of feel like between these two, I would be good. Now we get to lips, which I love. So I think about lips a little differently. There's the stuff that looks good and will stay on your face even as you wear a mask. And so there's a few of those that probably make sense for me to include. One of them that I've been loving is this Color Stay, Revlon Color Stay in number 14, Smoking Hot. It's this beautiful coral, gorgeous color. I love this shade, so I definitely want to bring this. And I like this formula. I've been enjoying it. So I'm going to go ahead and bring that with me. Let me see what else I want in the longwear department. You know what? We'll just leave it with these two. We're going to take NYX and we're going to take Revlon. Those are going to be our longwear lipsticks. I'm good with that. Then the other kind of like extreme, if I want to apply and reapply and I'm in my house and I'm not going anywhere and I just love the feel of something, I really like gloss. And so I've been really enjoying the Fenty Bubble Binge gloss, the new gloss that they came out with in the cream gloss. I just think that's a lot of fun. The other one from Fenty that I have been enjoying is orangey kind of gloss balm. So this is the cream formula and this is this. I feel like these two would be lots of fun and just great to have. I might just bring some of these like back and forth. I've really been enjoying the NARS lip products. I just enjoy across the board, but Laguna and also Dolce Vita in the Afterglow lip balm, as well as these two in their matte formula, Brief Encounter, as well as Unrestricted. So I'm bringing these four NARS lip products. I think I'm also gonna bring the Tower 28 Cashew lip gloss. It's just a really comfortable, easy formula that I feel like I can get somewhere with. And also I don't have like a cherry color, and I do like a cherry cherry-ish color. So maybe I will bring Bobbi Brown lipstick and the Crushed Shine lipsticks. I don't know, but I have it in this red, which is just a very soft red. Again, super easy to wear. So I feel like with these formulas and the two longwear, I'm pretty set. I feel like I've pretty much done all the damage I could have possibly done. Let me pack it up and see where we're at. I forgot eyeshadow primer. Very, very important. Okay, it doesn't look pretty inside, but it all fits. Here it is. So it seals up. That's what I really needed it to do. Nice and compact, easy for me to keep there. Oh, and by the way, Club Nebula did not fit. It is too darn bulky. I hope that you enjoyed that. It certainly kept me company talking to you guys, and like kind of hearing my own thought process was very helpful. And I hope that you all are able to travel soon, even if it's just to see family, if you haven't done that. I will definitely be in touch. I plan on filming some Miami specific content down there. Maybe we can raid my mom's makeup. I thought that would be fun. My mom probably has a lot of makeup, and or maybe raid my sister's travel bag, or I don't know, film out by the pool in the sunshine. Try to give you guys a different perspective, background. I hope everyone is doing really, really well, and we will talk soon. Okay, take care, everyone. Bye.